Today we are going to learn final accounts of sole trading concern. Why we are preparing final accounts? The main purpose of preparing accounts, accounts means the total accounts, journal, ledger, trial balance, to find profitability and financial position of the business concern. If you want to know the profitability and financial position of the business concern, we have to prepare final accounts. Yes. Today we are going to learn final accounts of sole trading concern. Yes. We are learning final accounts of sole trading concern. Final accounts is the last stage. Is the last stage in accounting cycle. Accounting cycle, we know business transactions are given, it should be converted into journal, journal into ledger, ledger into trial balance into trading, profit loss account and balance sheet, at last to opening entry. Yes, today we are going to prepare final accounts. It is the last stage in the accounting cycle. Second one, the purpose of preparing final accounts. One, to know profitability. Two, to know financial position. Students, once again, final accounts is the last stage in accounting cycle. The purpose of preparing final accounts, to know the profitability and to know the financial position of the business concern. The final accounts consisting of two parts. Namely, trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. So the final accounts consisting of two parts, namely trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. Trading profit and loss account is an account, is a ledger. Balance sheet is not a ledger, it is a statement. Trading profit and loss account prepared to find profitability. With the help of trading profit and loss account, we can ascertain profit or loss. With the help of balance sheet, we can ascertain financial position. Okay. First, we should look at trading profit and loss account. The final accounts consisting of two parts, the trading profit and loss account consisting of two parts, namely trading account and profit and loss account. First, we are going to learn the format of trading account. First, we should know what do you mean by trading. Trading means buying and selling. Buying means what? Purchase of goods. Selling means selling of finished goods. One more thing I want to share with you. The business concern, there are two. One is manufacturing concern, another one is buying and selling, that is trading concern. Manufacturing concern prepares trading profit loss account balance sheet. The trading concern, the concern which buys and sells, prepares profit and loss account. It will not prepare trading account. Yes, now we are preparing trading profit loss account for the manufacturing concern. Yes. What do you mean by trading? Trading means buying and selling. Buying means purchase. So trading account format, I am going to record, listen carefully. So profit and loss account debit side, we have to write purchase, because buying, purchases, we have two purchases, cash purchase, credit purchase. If we add these two, we'll get total purchase. We have to deduct purchase return. Students, we are learning trading account. Trading means buying and selling. Buying means purchase of goods. So trading account, debit side, cash purchase plus credit purchase, total purchase minus purchase return. Go to the credit side, we have to write sales, cash sales, credit sales, we'll get total sales minus sales return. The balancing figure we have to write in the outer column, that is called net sales. This is called net purchase. Okay, students. Trading means buying and selling. Buying means purchase, selling means sales. Okay. Then in trading account debit side, what all will come? Purchase expenses and purchase related expenses. What are all purchase related expenses? We have to buy the goods. If we buy goods, we have to pay carriage. Carriage on purchase. Or we can say freight on purchase. Carriage inwards or freight inwards. Next, when we buy goods from other state, we supposed to pay tax for transporting goods from one state to another state. That we called octroi. It should be debited. Octroi. When we buy goods from other country, we have to pay import duty. Import duty or custom duty. Next, then these are all purchase related expenses. Then we have to record manufacturing related expenses. What are all manufacturing related expenses? Wages paid for the production of goods. Wages, fuel, gas, water, fuel, gas, water, motive power or power, then factory expenses or manufacturing expenses. We have to record trading account debit side. So in trading account debit side, purchase related expenses and manufacturing related expenses. Okay, then trading account debit side starts with the opening stock. Trading account debit side starts with the opening stock. In opening stock, three items included, namely raw material, work in progress, another one is finished stock. Students, listen carefully. Opening stock which includes raw material, work in progress and finished stock. So trading account debit side starts with the opening stock. Sometime the overall closing stock is given, it should be debited directly. You can write in the outer column. Sometime the closing stock given in form of raw material, work in progress and finished stock, that time you have to write like this. So trading account debit side starts with the opening stock. Credit side, it ends with the closing stock. Closing stock also may have three items, such as raw material closing stock, work in progress closing stock, then finished goods closing stock. Add these three. So this is, we are learning trading account. Trading account debit side starts with the opening stock, ends with the closing stock. Then other items are purchase and purchase related expenses and manufacturing related expenses debited to the trading account. Now we are going to balance that. Trading account. This is credit side, trading account credit side. This is trading account debit side. Generally, the trading account credit side shows heavier balance than debit balance. So add the credit total, bring it to the debit side, then deduct all expenses, you will get one value. This we called gross profit. Gross profit CD. This gross profit should be transferred to profit and loss account. Here the credit total is heavier than debit total. Sometime the debit total may be heavier than credit total. That time add debit total first, bring it to the credit side, then find the balancing figure. That we called gross loss CD. gross loss also transferred to profit and loss account. This is the format of trading account: opening stock, closing stock, purchase expenses, purchase related expenses, and manufacturing related expenses. Overall, in trading account debit side, overall we can say direct expenses. These are all called direct expenses. So trading account debit side, direct expenses debited to trading account. So the expenses which are debited to the trading account, we can name it as direct expenses. Why we are calling it as direct expenses? If we stop any of these expenses, we cannot convert our raw material into the finished product. Listen students, trading account debit side, all direct expenses are recorded. Why we are calling it as direct expenses? It is directly related to the production process. If we stop any one expenses, which will affect the manufacturing process. So now we ascertained gross profit or gross loss. So by preparing trading account, we can ascertain gross profit or gross loss. Then the second stage called profit and loss account. So if it is gross profit, it should be transferred to the credit side of profit and loss account. If it is gross profit, transfer to the credit side of profit and loss account. If it is gross loss, transfer to the debit side of profit and loss account. Now we are learning the preparation of profit and loss account. Here I said the direct expenses are recorded. What do you mean by direct expenses? Expenses of purchase, expenses related to purchase, and manufacturing expenses debited to the trading account. Then the second stage is profit and loss account. Here indirect expenses are recorded. What are all indirect expenses? What do you mean by indirect expense? Indirect expense which are incurred to run the office. It's indirect expenses which are incurred to run the office. What are all indirect expenses? Administration, selling, distribution, and finance expenses. Administration, selling, distribution, and financial expenses called indirect expenses. Now I am going to write the indirect expenses. Salary paid at the office. Salary. Insurance premium paid. Next, postage, telephone charges. Then stationary expenses. Next, carriage on sales, or we can say freight outwards, we can say. Next, rent paid, commission paid, interest paid. Next, discount allowed. Students, listen carefully. Rent paid, commission paid, interest paid, and discount allowed. These are all paid expenses paid at the office level. If these are received, it should be credited to the profit and loss account. By commission received, by interest received, by discount received. So we should be very careful about these four items. In final accounts, namely rent, interest, commission, discount. If these are all paid, debited to the profit and loss account. If these are all received, credited to the profit and loss account. Listen students, if paid, debited to the profit and loss account, received, credited to the profit and loss account. Sometime paid or received is not given. That time we have to see the side of the item. If it is appeared in debit side, it will be recorded in the debit side. If it is appeared in the credit side, it will be in the credit side. Okay, next, bad debts. bad debts is a loss debited to profit loss account. If bad debts recovered are given, it is an income credited to the profit loss account. Then dividend in sole trading concern always received only. Then one more important item called apprenticeship premium. It is an income to the concern. It should be credited. Now we are going to balance the profit and loss account. Student, listen carefully. Here, this is profit and loss account. Always, the credit side of profit and loss account is heavier than debit side. So total the credit side, then bring it to the debit side. Deduct these expenses, you will get one value called net profit. This value called what? Net profit. No CDBD. The net profit transferred to capital account. Net profit should be transferred to the capital account. If credit side is more than the debit side, we'll get net profit. If debit side total more than the credit side, that time will the balance will be in the credit side, that we called net loss. Net loss, no CDBD. If it is net profit or net loss, it should be transferred to capital account. It should be transferred to the capital account. Students, trading account debit side, direct expenses are recorded. Profit and loss account debit side, indirect expenses are recorded. Profit and loss account credit side, other incomes are recorded. Now we are going to learn about the format of balance sheet. Students, one information I'm going to share with you. The final accounts are prepared on the basis of trial balance. So we are taking all the items from the trial balance. Now I'm going to show the format of balance sheet. Look at the balance sheet. Balance sheet, it is a statement. It is not an account. What is the difference between account and statement? In account, there is a debit and credit. In statement, no debit and credit. Here we have side. Balance sheet is a statement, not an account. It has two sides. Left hand side, liabilities are recorded. Right hand side, assets are recorded. Liability means payable to outsider. Assets means properties of the business. Liability means properties of the business. Yes, students, once again, we are preparing final accounts on the basis of trial balance. In trial balance, we have personal account, real account, and nominal account. In trial balance, all accounts are recorded, namely personal account, real account, nominal account. With the help of trial balance, we are preparing final accounts. So the personal and real accounts are recorded in the balance sheet. The nominal account recorded. So personal and real account recorded in the balance sheet. Nominal account recorded in the trading profit loss account. So the items which are recorded in the trading profit loss account balance sheet all are nominal accounts. So the remaining items are personal and real accounts are recorded in the balance sheet. Now balance sheet has two sides, liability and asset. First I am going to record the asset side. Cash in hand, cash at bank, closing stock, debtor also termed as book debts, investment, fixed deposit, premises, maybe business premises or freehold premises. Both are recorded in the asset side. Listen, student, premises, there are two: business premises, freehold premises. Any premises you can record on the asset side. Then land and building. Next, plant and machinery. Next, furniture and fittings. Loose tools, patent, trademark, patent, trademark, copyright, patent, trademark, copyright, these are all rights, these are all intellectual property rights enjoyed by the businessman. Patent right, trademark, copyright, these are all. Then loan debit value is given, it appears in the asset side. Likewise, suspense account. Sometimes the trial balance will not agree. The trial balance will not agree. The difference temporarily placed to the suspense account. If suspense account shows debit balance, it will appear in the asset side. At last, goodwill. These are all properties of the business. Then move to the liability. What I said, assets means properties. Liability means payable to outsider. What are all liability? Creditor, bills payable. If it is a bills receivable, is an asset. Creditor, bills payable, bank overdraft. We can call bank overdraft bank credit. So when we record bank, we should be very careful. If bank debit is given, it will appear in the asset side. Bank credit is given, it is called bank overdraft. Then bank loan. Then loan credit. Students, listen carefully. If loan is given, we should be very careful. If loan credit balance is given, liability. Debit balance is given, asset. Likewise, suspense account. Credit balance, it will appear in the liability. Then general reserve is an amount payable to the owner if there is no loss. General reserve also termed as reserve fund. Then liability side, capital, amount payable to the owner, add net profit. If net profit is given, if loss is given, we have to deduct net loss. Anyone will come. If net profit is given, add. If net loss is given, we have to deduct. So capital plus net profit or minus loss minus drawing, withdrawals of the owner. Then income tax considered to be drawings of the business. Now the balance sheet will agree. It will agree. If it is agree, our answer is correct. Students, once again, final accounts of sole trading concern we are learning. It is a last stage in accounting cycle. The purpose of preparing final accounts to know the profitability and financial position. With the help of trading profit loss account, we can ascertain profitability. With the help of balance sheet, we can ascertain financial position of the business. We are preparing final accounts on the basis of trial balance. In trial balance, there are two accounts, namely personal account, real account, nominal account. The nominal account items taken to the trading profit loss account. Personal and real account are recorded in the balance sheet. Trading account prepared to find gross profit or gross loss. Profit and loss account prepared to find net profit or net loss. Balance sheet prepared to find financial position of the business concerned. Students, today we learned the meaning of balance sheet, the introduction of final accounts and the format of trading profit loss account and balance sheet. In next class, we'll solve one problem relating to the final accounts. Till then, bye and thank you.